Mr. Sekhar Gupta, in his Cut the Cluster series, speaking on the Amaravati issue in Andhra Pradesh and the recent decision of the government to locate the three arms of the government in three different areas, was quite caustic in his remarks, terming it as the work of a Tughlaq to the cube, that somebody should have drunk or been on weed or things like that to take a decision like that. Unfortunately, he has forgotten one or two fundamental points which are relevant with reference to the location of the capital city in Andhra Pradesh. First and foremost, he's confusing between a mega city and a capital. Building up of a mega city is an entirely different thing. You can build it anywhere provided you have the necessary funds, and it's required also. I mean, we do lack good, well-functioning cities and we need to build them, and this can be done both by the state government as well as by the government of India. And they can be greenfield cities and they cost a lot. Let's not forget that. I mean, you may need a budget of about a lakh of rupees to build a well-planned, good, big city, metropolis, which is what Mr. Chandrababu Naidu was thinking of building Amaravati as. Then the issue of capital. Capital is always a political issue. There's nothing like deciding about capital without real politics. This is a point which he is forgetting. So location of a capital city is always a political compromise between different wings, different areas, different interests, different groups. That's what happened all through the history. Washington DC was not just like that picked upon for setting up of a capital city. It was a conscious compromise arrived at between the northerners and southerners to set it up there as part of a deal. So is the manner in which Canberra was set up in Australia. Has any such dialogue, discussion leading to a compromise or a consensus preceded the decision of Chandrababu Naidu when he decided to locate it at Amaravati? Unfortunately not. That's the crux of the problem. Andhra Pradesh, after Telangana was separated from it, is still a state with three distinct regional areas with their own unique identities, like the Rayalaseema, the coastal Andhra, the north coastal Andhra. In fact, you can also say south coastal Andhra, so that may not be much of an issue. You can broadly divide them into the Rayalaseema, the coast, and the north coast, and all of them have their own interests and would like to be represented in the capital city. And it has a history, and that's a point which he seems to have totally forgotten. It's a history dating back to pre-independence era. Pre-independence era, Rayalaseema threatened to stay back with Madras state if their wishes to locate the capital city were not conceded. That's when the gentlemen from both the areas, the Andhra area and the Rayalaseema area, sat together and wrote down an informal agreement which is known as Sribhag Pact. As per this Sribhag Pact, if the capital is located in Rayalaseema, the High Court is to be located in Andhra Pradesh or vice versa. And the first choice is to be given to the Rayalaseema on this. It was this principle which decided setting up of the capital at Kurnool in 1953 before, as part of a much bigger Andhra Pradesh, Vishal Andhra, it moved over to Hyderabad. These are historical legacies and facts which cannot be forgotten while taking a decision on the capital city. That exactly what Mr. Chandrababu Naidu did, because of which all these repercussions are coming over now. So a decision to review that decision of locating the capital city, all functions together at Amaravati, by a successor government cannot be termed either as vindictive or because of missing out on an opportunity to do something, and all these things are not the right things. It is a logical outcome of a reaction to a decision which was arrived at without any consensus or bringing out a discussion and a decision which was done at that time. Then he goes on to add about having a decent metropolis to live in without slums. Everybody would like to have that. That's not the issue. But can you have that? That's the point. Brasilia was built with that type of a thinking only, that we will build a greenfield, beautiful city without slums. And the slums started developing even before Brasilia came, because all those who came to work there started living in slums. So also you have slums in Bhuvaneshwar, which is built as a model town, replicating a New Delhi. Similar is Chandigarh. You have slums everywhere, including Navi Bombay. So to think that a systematically well-planned city will be without slums is just ignoring the reality. So slums is one aspect. A desire not to have a metropolis without slums will only be fulfilled when there is a higher rate of growth and the income levels of the people improve. Till that time, we'll have to carry on with the slums. And then the idea of the location of the benches, court benches also, I was finding fault with. But I think that's a normal procedure. Everywhere you have a high court at one place and bench in different places. In Chennai, the high court is in Chennai, the bench is in Madurai. So this high court benches being at different places is a general thing. Similarly, location of the high court away from the capital city is a fact of life in about a dozen states within India. So why is he finding fault with all of them and then say such caustic words as this is the action of a Tughlaq, or that somebody has smoked or is on a drink or etc. I think that was totally uncalled for. And his appreciation of the historical legacy and the facts, as well as the confusion between a capital city and a mega city, seems to have landed him in giving some expert opinion without a proper understanding of the issues involved. Thank you.